A lot of people told me, God only gives you what you can handle. I can handle a lot. I can take a lot. My son, he's a strong boy. He can handle a lot. I can't handle losing him. My Aidan, he is awesome, sweet, great, amazing, bratty, frustrating, tough.
I'm Gangsta Panda!
He's very open with people.
I love you, Aidan.
He's independent, more independent than I would have ever thought. He's funny.
This is Aidan's cooking show.
He laughs all the time. He makes other people laugh. He teaches other kids to be appreciative of what they have. He's a good boy all around. Aidan has Duchenne's muscular dystrophy. That's basically a muscle wasting disease. He was diagnosed when he was 3 years old. Aiden's dad took him to the appointment. Dad just shook his head. When a doctor tells you your son has a terminal disease, it just... It came out perfect. 10 toes, 10 fingers. And he still is perfect. He's my baby, he's always gonna be, and he is... Ooh, that boy's tough.
Respect, honesty, trustworthy, and always follows through. And it's Aiden.
He said about the age of 10 is when he'll start to lose the ability to walk, and then it just sort of graduates from there.
Aw.
You got it, buddy.
They say the life expectancy for boys with this disease is late teens, early 20s. 26 is a, you know, goal. Aiden, he handles it well. I think he knows more about it than I do. I got to talk to Dr. Asher. I just mentioned that my son was handicapped. And he asked what he asked. And I told him, and he just looks at me like, what? And he's like, that's what I'm supposed to work with. And I was like, what do you work with? And he's like, stem cell research. And I was like, oh, what?
The conversation with Melissa was the kind of conversation that typically would be scary for anyone in medicine, any physician, because, you know, up until recently, there was nothing you could do for Duchenne's. And this conversation was different, however.
The doctor told me they want to work with Aiden, they want to work with Duchenne's, and that this could possibly stop the progression.
In addition to our current 20-year-old practice, American Medical Aesthetics and Regenerative Medicine, Dr. Pien and I have another practice called AIMS, which stands for Advanced Integrative Medicine and Surgery, which is focused on the research and development of the new things, the new horizons of regenerative and integrative medicine. And of course, stem cells are a huge part of that. Now, the beautiful thing about the way AIMS is structured is that we also have a 501c3, which is a charitable foundation, which allows people to donate to the foundation, which then funds the necessary research to provide, for instance, the treatments that Aiden needs to hopefully stem and slow down and reverse and even heal him from his Duchenne's.
I always say, let have hope, have hope. Since meeting the doctor, this is the first time I have hope. You have to just have hope. There's someone out there that's gonna try for your son the way you try for your son. He's gonna try and make it so your son can stay being your son forever.